The Book of Esther is one of the very few biblical stories with a female heroine. The tale takes place in ancient Persia.
Esther, a young maiden who happens to be Jewish, is chosen to be the new queen but hides her identity for most of the story until the evil villain Haman plots to annihilate all of the Jews, and Esther has to work up the courage to approach the king to reveal her true identity and to stand up in order to save her people, and ultimately she does.
Every little Jewish girl growing up wants to be like Esther and dress up for the Purim holiday like the queen who saves the day. But this year, for the first time ever, there's a twist. Maybe Esther, the female protagonist of the Purim Megillah or the Purim Scroll, is not the only hero in the story. Apparently, a marginal character named Vashti deserves much of the credit. She's the first queen who was expelled by the king and was replaced by Esther.
Vashti is only mentioned really in the first chapter of the Megillah. She is quickly banished from the palace. King Ahasuerus asks that Vashti appear before him and all of his drunken friends at a party wearing her crown, and the rabbis say wearing only her crown, in order to dance and display her beauty. And Vashti refuses. It is inappropriate. It is sexually insulting to her. And so she's the first woman who stands up and says no. She's the first, in a sense, me too.
To lift up her character and celebrate Persian Queen Vashti alongside Jewish Queen Esther, about 60 women from the Jewish Reform community of Rye, New York, gathered for a Purim celebration. Instead of the traditional reading of the Purim Megillah, this year they decided to come up with a play, the Megillah Monologues.
Just like the Vagina Monologues, where there are women sitting on bar stools talking, that's what we're going to have. Only we're going to use the characters of the Purim story, and we'll get the perspective from the women who are there.
He was so mad, he even issued an edict saying every man should rule in his own house.
I never imagined I'd be queen.
Killing the Jews was at first my idea.
What?
They joke that Esther was elected queen in an episode of The Bachelor.
None of these chicks was going to get a rose.
They compare the women of Shushan, the ancient capital of the Persian Empire, to the Kardashians.
And yet you couldn't help but love her. Kind of the way you feel about the Kardashians.
And so a biblical tale that goes back more than 2,500 years gets a modern interpretation. Not only that the Jews of Persia were saved from annihilation, but also the women of ancient Persia decided their own destiny.
Our Persian Jewish heroines, the first that she persisted. Of today, brave women we will be.
Tal Heinrich, I-24 News.